Team America. This is your boy, Staff Sergeant Rodriguez, U.S. Army recruiter, just like my hat says right there. Whew. All right, U.S. City, here in California. All right, guys, let me start this video off by telling you that today we're going to talk about the, five survival tips that I have for you for boot camp, right? For basic combat training in the United States Army. Right, boom, comes from my experience and from experiences that I've heard also from my future soldiers that actually went through boot camp and became officially soldiers. So without further ado, let's go with the first one. Boom, personal experience real quick, and already the other side have experience, and this comes with the Eagle's cash card. Ka-ching, ka-ching, right? You get that little Eagle cash card, and we call it like that because it's an advance payment of your own salary. That once you get over there after reception week of boot camp, or within reception week of boot camp, you get this card that has an eagle in front of it. It's a cash card, you know, it's a government card, right? It's an advance pay, so they're gonna give you about up to like 200 bucks for you to actually buy this extra stuff like hygiene stuff, right? PT shoes, right? Running shoes and all that good stuff. So remember, that's your money. That is your money. It's not the government's money, it's yours. So use it wisely, right? I didn't because I thought it was free money. I was like, ka-ching, ka-ching, swiping everything. And then I see my very first paycheck. I'm like, whoa, what happened? I'm missing like 300 bucks up in here. I spent it all, man. So what I want you to do with that, survival tip number one, use your cash card wisely and buy foot powder. Buy foot powder, right? I'm telling you, and cut them nails. So to clip your toes and foot powder, so because you're going to be doing all these ruck marches and running a lot, stuff like that, you want to take care of your feet, right? Take care of your feet and get them good socks too, right? All right, moving on from that, every time a dress owner talks to you or whatever may have you, boom, simple. I'm not going to expand on this. You already know what happens if you don't listen. Roger, drill sergeant. Roger, drill sergeant, right? With no attitude, you're like, Roger, this sergeant, boom, and just move on, boom. All right. Survival tip number three at boot camp. Got you, if you're a dude, right? You should shave the night prior, right? And then wake up extra earlier than the day after because you don't want to make that line. And it gets really packed up in that bathroom. It's just a bunch of dudes trying to shave their faces, right? It wasn't so bad for me because I had to shave like every 3 days or so. But for you guys out there, I have like, boom, like son of anarchy. The night prior, it'll do you some good. I know it'll grow overnight. That's why you wake up extra early and just here and there, a little bit here and there, right? Just to have it clean, right? Now, tip number four right there, survival at boot camp. This is what I want you to do. If you're a male, right, cut your hair low before you go to boot camp. So that way you're already surviving in boot camp because you're already took care of that. And it's not like this civilian's gonna like, you know, like mess up your head. Have it low, you know, just don't have a fro or long hair because it's gonna mess you up, man. They just do one and one clip type only, and so that's the zero. Real quick, move on. Right now, the last but not least, survival tip. Boot camp number cinco, five, is to volunteer to serve CHOW, right? For me, this is more for the skinny dudes out there and skinny gals. If you volunteer to serve CHOW, which is food, right? Breakfast, lunch, and dinner, it's volunteers. So you'll be the first one to actually see all the food, get the best stuff, eat before everybody comes in, and then you serve the food, right? It's awesome. I went and did it with my butter buddies, and then it was like we all bonded. It was like, yeah, we're the first one. Yeah, we have to make no line. We already ate, and there's no rush. There's no rush. You don't have like 3 or 5 minutes to eat that. No, you volunteer to serve CHOW. They're like, take your time, son, right? But just don't take too much of time, right? Because then you have to serve everybody else, but you get the best. The best of the best. You see everything, right? So, boom, volunteer to serve CHOW. That's the best one that I have to offer, right? Right there. And, oh, one more. That's it. One more, right? That's it. This is bonus right here. They're going to give you 4 to up to 5 sets of Army combat uniforms, right? Those Army greens, right? Only use 2 of them for training. The other 3 or 2 that you have left, do not use them at all. Those are the ones you want to, you know, have all fancy and stuff like that. So by the time you show up to your first unit and stuff like that, you have a brand new one. You don't have to buy all this extra stuff, right? So you don't like tap in so much into your clothing allowance that you get every anniversary of your from the time that you join. Boom, that's it. Hey, Team America, happy 2021. Accomplish your goals. Woo! Team Ra America. Ah!